Hello students, in today's video we will study about the formula for wavelength of emitted spectral line, energy level diagram of hydrogen atom, excitation energy and excitation potential, ionization energy and ionization potential, de Broglie wavelength and Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. At first let us take the formula for wavelength of emitted spectral line. Energy of electron of hydrogen atom in nth stationary orbit is given by the relation En is equal to minus m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square n square h square. Therefore, when the electron jumps from orbit n2 to orbit n1 by emitting a photon of wavelength lambda and frequency f, then En2 minus En1 will be equal to h into f, which will be equal to hc upon lambda, or putting the values of En2 and En1 from this relation, we get minus m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square h square n2 square minus m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square h square n1 square is equal to hc upon lambda. Taking m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square h square common, we get hc upon lambda is equal to m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square h square into 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square. 1 upon lambda will be equal to m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square h cube into c into 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square, where constant m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square c h power cube, c into h power cube, can be replaced by another constant capital R, where capital R is equal to m e to power 4 upon 8 epsilon naught square c into h power 3, which gives value 1.097 into 10 to power 7 per meter. After putting the values of constants in this relation, this constant R is known as Rydberg's constant. So the relation is 1 upon lambda is equal to R into 1 upon n1 square minus 1 upon n2 square. Next we take spectrum. The orderly arrangement of wavelengths or frequencies in increasing or decreasing order is called spectrum. The spectra of different wavelengths obtained when the electrons in the excited state jump to lower state is called emission spectra. Similarly, the spectra of different wavelengths obtained when the electrons in the excited state jump to higher state is called absorption spectra. Next, excitation energy and excitation potential. The minimum amount of energy required to raise an electron from its ground state to an excited state, except n is equal to infinity, is called excitation energy. Thus, excitation energy is equal to the energy difference between excited orbit energy and ground orbit energy. That is, delta E is equal to E excited minus E ground. The corresponding potential is called excitation potential. For example, for hydrogen atom, first excitation energy is equal to E2 minus E1 E2 minus E1 which will be equal to E2 is minus 13.6 upon 2 square minus 13.6 upon 1 square electron volt, which gives 10.2 electron volt. Thus, the excitation potential for the second orbit of hydrogen atom will be 10.2 electron volt. Therefore, excitation potential will be equal to 10.2 eV upon E, which gives 10.2 volts. Next, the ionization energy and ionization potential. The minimum amount of energy required to completely eject an electron from its atom is called ionization energy, and the corresponding potential is called ionization potential. For example, for hydrogen atom, ionization energy will be equal to E infinity minus E1. So, it will be equal to minus 13.6 eV upon n square means infinity square minus 13.6 eV upon 1 square, which gives 13.6 eV. And when it is divided by electronic charge E, we get ionization potential. So, 13.6 eV upon E is equal to 13.6 volt, which is the ionization potential of hydrogen atom. Next, we take the energy level diagram of hydrogen atom. In excited state, electron spends 10 to minus 8 seconds and then comes back to the initial state, giving a spectral line. Figure 1 shows the energy level diagram of hydrogen atom. Spectral lines related to n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2, 3 and so on form Lyman series and so on. Thus, these lines form Lyman series, which lies in the ultraviolet region of spectrum. Similarly, the spectral lines from n is equal to 2 to the upper orbits form Balmer series, which lies in the visible region. Similarly, Pasten series lies in the infrared region and so on. The first spectral line of Lyman series is denoted by H alpha. Second spectral line of Lyman series is denoted by H beta, and third line of Lyman series is denoted by H gamma. These are the energies of different energy levels calculated from relation En is equal to minus 13.6 eV upon n square, corresponding to n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. We can find the wavelength of any spectral line of this spectrum using this relation, where R is Rydberg constant. For example, if we put N1 is equal to 1 and N2 is equal to 2, then we get the wavelength of H alpha line of Lyman series and so on. Next, we take de Broglie hypothesis. In 1984, Louis de Broglie suggested dual nature of matter. According to him, the moving particle sometimes behave as a particle and sometimes as a wave associated with the moving particle. These waves are called de Broglie waves, and the corresponding wavelength is known as de Broglie wavelength, which is given by the relation lambda is equal to h upon p, where h is Planck's constant and p is linear momentum. Proof. From Planck's theory of radiation, the energy of a photon is given by E is equal to h into f is equal to hc upon lambda, equation 1. And from Einstein's mass energy relation, E is equal to mc square, which can be written as m into c, and m into c is the mass into velocity, that is linear momentum, and so it becomes linear momentum p into c. Equation 2, equating 1 and 2, we get hc upon lambda is equal to p into c, cc cancels out, and we get lambda as h upon p, which is de Broglie wavelength formula. Now we take de Broglie wavelength in terms of kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is given as E k is equal to half mv square, which can be written as half m into m upon m into v square, which gives 1 upon 2m into m into v whole square, and m into b whole square becomes p square. So kinetic energy Ek is equal to p square upon 2m, which gives p is equal to under root 2m into k, equation 1. And from de Broglie formula, p is equal to h upon lambda, equation 2, equating 1 and 2, we get h upon lambda is equal to under root 2m under root 2m into Ek, which gives lambda as h upon under root 2m into Ek. Next, we take Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. This principle was formulated by German physicist Werner Heisenberg in 1927 and got Nobel Prize in 1932. Its statement is, it is impossible to determine precisely and simultaneously the values of both the members of a pair of conjugate variables which describe the motion of the particle. First equation is delta x into delta p is greater or equal to h upon 2 pi. Second is delta e into delta t is equal or greater to h upon 2 pi. Third is delta theta into delta l, which is equal or greater than h upon 2 pi. H upon 2 pi is also written as h cut, which is 1.054 into 10 to minus 34 joule second. Here delta x represents the uncertainty in the measurement of position. Similarly, delta p represents the uncertainty in the measurement of linear momentum. Here E is energy, t is time, theta is angular displacement, and l is angular momentum.